What is going on, guys? It's Kitten of Doom, and in today's video, we are going to be going over everything you need to know about how to play Assault. I'm going to be going over some tips and tricks that will help make your overall Assault experience more enjoyable. If you don't know what Assault is, it's a 5v5 game mode that selects a completely random god for you to play. The map has one lane with two towers and a phoenix on each side. You are only given a god that you currently own, so you won't be given a god you haven't unlocked yet unless you have the god pack. In Assault, you can switch gods with a teammate if you both own the same god. This is helpful if you are better with some gods than others, but you can't trade with people who don't own the current god you have. You can also accept or decline trade requests from your teammates. You are also allowed to reroll a god for favor. You can only reroll one time, so once you reroll, you are stuck with the god you have. It is extremely important to never reroll a healer like Chang'e, Aphro, Sylvanas, Guan Yu, Ra, and Hell, so that your whole team can sustain longer in lane. Usually Assault gives a healer to each side, so it is important to keep your healer so that the enemy team doesn't out-sustain you. Healers aren't given in every game, so just remember to never reroll them. In Assault, it is also important to reroll your god if you have multiple gods of the same class, like if you have three assassins or three guardians. Try to get a balanced team. A god in each role is preferred, but isn't always easy to get with the randomization. You should also reroll if you have four physical or magical gods on your team. The reason why you'd want to reroll in this situation is because you could get easily counter-built by the enemy warrior or guardian, since all they would have to do is build all physical or magical defense. Also pay attention to the other team's composition, like how many magical or physical gods they have. If they have a lot more magical gods on their team, and you're a tank, it is important to remember to mainly focus on magical defense. Once you do this, you'll be extremely hard to kill, and you will also be a big pain in the ass for them to deal with. Always get meditation as your first relic. It helps your whole team stay in lane longer, and you can also save teammates from death. Meditation is also extremely useful when most of your team has ran out of mana. The only situation I could see not building meditation first is when you don't have a CC immune ultimate and are against an Ares. After meditation, you are free to pick up whichever relic you prefer. If they have a lot of big crowd control ultimates, I would recommend beads, but if they don't, Aegis is a great relic that helps you stay alive. If you are a support, I would recommend building shell or sprint to help out your team. The reason why meditation and healers are so important in Assault is because you can't go back to the fountain to heal or buy items. The only way to fully heal and buy items is if you die. This is what makes Assault so interesting and fun to play. Yes, it can be hard at first, but it really helps to test out your skills. Another reason why Assault is so great to learn is that it gives you totally random gods, which forces you to learn new gods all the time. Knowing how to play every god in Smite helps to make you become a better player since you know exactly what you are going to go up against. Dying in Assault is extremely important. You need to calculate when the right time to die is. If you have 4 to 7,000 gold in hand, it's a pretty good indicator that you need to kick it. Dying is also important because if a bunch of your teammates die at the same time, the enemy will have plenty of time to take 1 to 2 towers in the downtime. It is crazy how fast towers can disappear on a deicide. If you are the only person alive trying to defend a tower, let it go. It is more important for you to stay alive and defend further back so that your team can revive and come help you. Since Assault is completely randomized, it is a high possibility that your enemy team will get a better composition than you do. That is what sucks about Assault, but it also makes Assault really challenging and fun. I want to go over starting builds for each class. In Assault, you start off with 3,000 gold, so you can start off with a full expensive item. Do not buy boots first. It is a waste of gold at the beginning because you don't really need the extra movement speed since you will be crammed into one lane at the beginning. For mages, I recommend Chronos Pendant because it gives you passive MP5 so that you won't really have any mana problems in lane. It also gives you really great cooldown for your abilities. Another good pickup would be Bancroft's Talon for some lifesteal sustain. For hunters, I would always recommend getting Bloodforge. Bloodforge's passive and assault is really strong since it gives you a shield when you kill an enemy god. Bloodforge is the best item if you want to try to get double, triple, and even pentakills. Assassins can also pick up Bloodforge. I sometimes start off with Jotun's Wrath to help with mana and cooldowns. Warriors and supports should pick up either Sovereignty or Heart Ward. Heart Ward is a great aura item that helps your teammates gain magical protection as well as gain back some mana. Sovereignty is great because it gives your teammates an aura of physical protection. Warriors can start off with Hide of the Urchin as well. If you want to be a more damage-oriented warrior, a good pickup would be Jotun's Wrath. Don't forget to stock up on health and mana potions. I always like to keep stocked up when I die so that I can have some extra sustain and survivability out in lane. It is important to remember that an assault game can turn really quickly due to long respawn timers the further you get into the game. Try not to surrender, because I have came back from many of what seemed like hopeless games. Remember that everyone starts out at level 5, so everyone has access to their ultimates when the game starts. You want to be extremely careful to not get stuck in everyone's ultimate chain, especially during dance parties. If you don't know what dance parties are, it is when everyone jumps around each other at the beginning of the match before the minions come to lane. Be really careful when doing this, because the enemy team can turn on you in an instant and then they will get a lead. That is going to wrap up this assault guide. Let me know if this has helped you at all, and also comment down below if you'd like any other game mode tutorials. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye!